إن الحمد لله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله مالك يوم الدين الحمد لله الذي إياه نعبد وإياه نستعين اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الفضل كله ولك الخير كله اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لعظيم وجهك وجلال سلطانك وإن كان جهد الحمد لا يفي بشكر نعمة واحدة من نعم الله عليك اللهم اغفر لي تقصيري في حمدك كما ينبغي لعظيم وجهك وجلال سلطانك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله إله الأولين والآخرين وقيوم السماوات والأرضين الذي لا عز إلا في طاعته وحده ولا غنى إلا في الافتقار إليه وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وصلى الله على ملائكتك المقربين وأنبيائك والمرسلين وصل علينا معهم يا كريم Indeed, all praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such we should praise Him. Even with all the act of praise, all the effort of praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not enough to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for one single bounty, ni'mah, He bestowed upon us. Oh Allah, forgive us, forgive me, my shortcoming in your deen, praising you as it should be. And I bear witness, there is no true deity worthy of existence but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no true deity worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is last the messenger and the best worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, you believe? Be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us His guidance. The topic that I like to speak, al-ihtisab fi al-Qur'an al-Kareem. Relying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward, al-ihtisab, come from the root hasaba, adda, count. Or relying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, Surah Al-Anfal, Ya ayyuha al-Nabi, hasbuka Allah, wa man ittaba'aka min al-mu'mineen. O Prophet of Allah, do all kind of work, good deed, only hasbuk Allah. Allah is the one who counted this for you. Allah is the one who gives you the credits. Don't look for credits in this dunya. Hasbuk Allah. وَمَنْ اتَّبَعَكَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ And those who follow you from the believer. So the believer driving force is to please Allah and Allah alone. Hasbuk Allah. Only Allah He's the one who rewards you. Don't look for credit around you. Don't look to be known around you. حسبك الله ومن اتبعك من المؤمنين. Even in Surah At-Tawbah, the last verse, فإن تولوا, if everyone walk away from you, فإن حسبك الله. لا إله إلا هو رب العرش العظيم. The only deity worthy of existence, the only deity worthy of worship, رب العرش العظيم, is the Lord of all that exists and that we know and what we don't know. All you could visualize in this dunya. فَإِنْتَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. Coming out from graduation of Ramadan, you learn intensive course, 30 days of worship, 9 prayer, fasting during the day, 10th course to elevate al-ihtisab, relying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone to reward you. In a secular society, they promote altruism, do good deeds for nothing, help other for nothing, do good things for nothing. Auguste Comte in the 19th century, he developed this idea, do good for nothing, absolutely nothing. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planted for the believer, total submission believer, the true believer. There is two types of belief. You believe generally that there is a creator, and you accept generally what Allah said in His scripture. But there is type of belief that moves your heart and your thoughts and your will, your irada, toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This belief, al-ihtisab on Allah, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the ultimate giver for your deed. Al-ihtisab on Allah term the normal act you do to become an act of worship. Raising your children, if you do it muhtasib on Allah, you gain benefit in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything you do will turn the normal act into act of worship. Al-ihtisab on Allah will prevent the act of worship from not being mechanical act of worship. You just do to pass time. You just do because it says so, mechanically, no emotion, no thoughts, no development. Al-ihtisab ala Allah, very important to the believer, to have it in your heart and your thoughts. And this is very tricky. No one will have access to know your real driving force. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us examples for those who only have Allah in their heart. In Surah Al-Imran, verse 172. الَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْقَرْحِ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا مِنْهُمْ وَاتَّقَوْا أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَاخْشَوْهُمْ فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله. Those who follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Allah, when he called them after the defeat of Uhud, the reason of the revelation of these three verses. After the defeat of Uhud,
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost 70 shaheed. Many wounded. الَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ. This was Saturday. Saturday, calamity happened. Defeat. Killing. But Saturday, the historian says, weeping and crying in a masjid, even the Prophet felt sorry. ولكن حمزة لا بواكي له. No one cried for Hamza. But someday, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent a command to the believer, the wounded one, around 600. When he got the news that the Meccanians want to try to conquer Medina again after Uhud, الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. They prepared for you. Have fear of them. فزادهم إيمانا. This is increased their belief. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم decided to move and meet them in حمراء الأسد, a place 20 miles of Medina. And he commanded only those who participate in Uhud, not those who withdraw. About 30% draw out. They don't participate. The hypocrites. He says, not from them. He took only the wounded one, the believer one. الَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْقَرْحِ. After they being wounded, after they being hurt, they move back to meet them in حمراء الأسد. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ. They have prepared for you a huge army. They will vanish you from the face of the earth. But Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he have a different plan. He went to meet them in حمراء الأسد, waiting for them to come. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. This situation increased their iman in their hearts. وَقَالُوا, and their statement, their slogan and their face, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ. قَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ. Allah is the one who benefits us. Allah is our driving force. We do what is necessity to do. حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. He is the only one who could rely on and trust. No one else. No one else will count. حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. In the second verse, فَانْخَلَقُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ. They return back with bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They gained their self-esteem after the defeat of Uhud. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. None of them got hurt. The Meccanian back off. The Meccanian turn back when they hear that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was coming with his own group, with his own few believers, around 600. They're gonna face 3,000. But they gave their self-esteem from قَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلًا لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ. الإمام رضي الله عنه says, this word, this statement, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, it was enough for the whole army. Not gonna be enough for you as individual. Al-Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq, he died 148 Hijriya. He taught Al-Imam Abu Hanifa. He said this statement alone was full enough for the whole army to benefit from and give them their self-esteem back.
فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل والفاء للترتيب والتعقيم. The letter of faith that after their statement, it's not just a song or an act of a tongue. This is their statement. It's like something very solid in their heart and their thoughts. This is what they mean. Not just this what they say with their tongue. And there's a huge separation in the modern Muslim world between what they say in a tongue, what they really are, what their intention are. And it's huge separation between what they say, what they are, and what they act. A huge separation. Allah says in Surah Al-Anbiya, verse number 10, لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. We reveal to you a revelation, have your story. The early generation, they read فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. All their errors, the Quran fixed their errors. Analyze their errors, so they could fix themselves up. This generation also, if they want the solution, they could go deeper. Read between lines and read between letters. لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. This revelation have yourselves. Muslim communities, but no Muslim. We live while Muslim, but not Muslim community. كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. All your errors must be fixed. Younger generation, they go to school. They learn poems and novels. They write about it. They write posters. They act the novels. They write 5-paragraph essay. What they understand. What the theme is. Point proof analysis. But when it comes to the Quran, they don't have to write. They don't know the language. And they don't know even what this means. And you expect them to start to struggle in a secular agnostic atheist society. Whereas man read with his eyes and think with his feeling. No rational, no thinking, no investigations, no research. لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Do you have your reasoning? You are truly want to solve yourselves? All what you see have the answer. Take it serious and serious enough. لَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ كِتَابًا فِيهِ ذِكْرِكُمْ. Who you are? Are you from قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتٍ خَاشِعُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. Are you from those believers that they are stay away from nonsense, that they don't repeat information that they don't know, they don't reject truths, they don't promote lies, عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. Or from those who says مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرَ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُن مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ ولم نكن نطعم المسكين وكنا نخوض مع الخائضين. When you look at yourself as an individual and as community as well, what you care? Did you do brainstorming to save yourselves from what's surrounding you? Did you have a solutions? What is it? How much you could build that? Are you serious about it? So when the calamity come, by all means, it must come. It's normal to come. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. All you believe, مَنْ يَرْتَدَّ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِي اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَعِزَّةٍ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ يُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ولا يخافون لهم لائم. All you believe, if you think yourself giving Allah a favor, because you are a Muslim, فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. They're only focused that Allah loves them, and they love them back. They love Him back, and they want to serve Allah through His community. They want to serve the community, not abuse that one another. يحبهم ويحبون أدلة على المؤمنين أعزة على الكافرين يجاهدون في سبيل الله ولا يخافون لومة لائم. This is كتابا فيه ذكركم. A revelation of your story. You must go deeper and study. Don't waste time. Life is short. Understand and comprehend. Make sure you understand. Make sure you read books that make you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make sure you love to know Allah through His creation. Then you will know Allah, the Almighty, how He is, what He wants from us, and how we be good to one another in a real sense, not a verbal sense. أنزلنا عليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم أفلا تعقلون. Learn until you know what is it. Why the Arab cannot produce Quran? The Muslims, there is a reason. Need introductions. You must hold this, it's available. But need to study. Need to know the environment and the language. Then you'll have the miraculous. Why is it? Then you will know. No one will defeat you in your faith. Then your faith grows knowledge. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقِّ وَيَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. Those who have knowledge, the true one, not just a looking one, not just a degree one. You got your degree. You got your degree meaning you could breathe in this field. Keep reading and study. No. Many people, they stop reading in their 20s. No new ideas. No energy. No growing. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ. Only those who have knowledge, they will know. They will see. And Allah used the word يَرَى. You will see it visually. الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ. This revelation is the truth only if you have knowledge. وَيَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَيَهْدِي إِلَى صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. Absolute truth is in a secular relativist society that destroy the concept of truth is. يَرَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ الَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ ويهدي إلى صراط العزيز الحميد. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الاحتساب على الله it's very important. عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه says أيها الناس احتسبوا أعمالكم على الله. Only rely in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards. No one reward as long as you do the right things from your the right heart. Usamah ibn Zayd reports one of the daughters of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She had an infant and about to die. So she sent a message to the Prophet, come and participate in the death of my son. Your grandson. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he said him back, اصبري واحتسبي. Be patient and rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All your harm, all your pain. Be patient, it's enough. لله ما أخذ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us from nothing. And He's only one beside. Where are you going to go? You are belonging to Him. اصبري واحتسبي. Practicing ihtisab is hard. Need a lot of striving. Need a lot of focus in anything that you do. Not only the act of worship. Anything that you practice in your life. You just have your intention. You do it to please Allah. This is enough. Will stop from you stop you from practicing the act of worship as things you have to do mechanically. Al-Muhtasib always count his life, minutes and hours toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go back to the Quran and read the application of ihtisab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from his knowledge. Academic dua, please say ameen. اللهم اهدنا بفضلك فيمن هديت. اللهم يا ارحم الراحمين ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعه يا كريم. اللهم استرنا فوق الارض وتحت الارض ويوم العرض عليك. اللهم ات قلوبنا تقواها وزكها يا رب انت خير من زكاها. اللهم اصلح احوالنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا. اللهم ابعث لشباب المسلمين من هم اعمق فكرا ومن هم ارحب صدرا ومن هم اكثر وعيا. اللهم ارفع غضبك عنا يا كريم. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم ارفع عنهم ظلم الجبارين. اللهم ارفع عنهم ظلم الجبارين. اللهم ارفع عنهم ظلم الجبارين. اللهم ارفع عنهم تدبير الخائنين. اللهم ارفع عنهم تدبير الخائنين. اللهم ارفع عنهم كيد الكائدين. اللهم ارفع عنهم كيد الكائدين. ربنا هذا حالنا لا يخفى عليك. وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر وماثل بين يديك. فتجلى علينا بحفظك. وتجلى علينا بفضلك وعملنا بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك وأقم الصلاة.